Well, at the end of this conference on power and inequality, we can surely say that we have made some steps, small or big, but it's important towards walking and to continue walking. So we have made some small or big steps towards a better understanding of the problem, towards better understanding of the policy options that are available to all of us, and towards a clearer awareness that Europe cannot continue its lukewarm attitudes towards poverty and inequality, because they are a serious threat for the deep security of our social model. The conference stimulated the propagation of ideas and the sharing of best practices, and I thank all of you for your important inputs. We have had with us more than 400 participants from a wide variety of backgrounds. 55 countries are represented in this conference. More than 100 civil society organizations participated. All this demonstrates that within our societies there is a strong interest to find alternative paths to reduce inequalities and precariousness. The conference has come at a very timely moment. We are all eyewitnesses that the economic and financial crisis and the change processes triggered by this crisis are creating a new social class, the precariate, as one of the experts described it during the conference. The conference allowed us to reflect about the real meaning of poverty in today's Europe, and it gave us an opportunity to consider all the main dimensions of poverty, not only the purely economic ones. We explored topics that are not usually discussed when addressing the question of poverty and inequality. Let me just mention a few of them. The fight against waste, as described by Tally Hoban. The preservation and enlargement of common goods, presented by Ugo Mattei. The sharing of responsibility by all stakeholders. The better cooperation between the state and public authorities and the different social actors to ensure dignity for all, as illustrated by Jacob von Uxkull, if I said it well. The conference also launched the guidebook, Living in Dignity in the 21st Century. Beyond the analysis of the relationship between human rights, democracy and poverty, this manual proposes a series of policy measures enabling progress towards less polarization and more social justice. And what are the outcomes of this conference? Let me offer some tentative conclusions. First of all, the conference helped us defining a new approach to anti-poverty measures, an approach which rejects stigmatization and which is not only based on the financial help of the states. The second conclusion is that in order to promote this new vision, we need to send a clear message that conventional policies alone are unable to provide the required answer to the current situation of increasing precariousness and instability. The conference also demonstrated very clearly that difficulties in accessing social rights have enormous consequences for the exercise of civil and political rights. And that, in turn, affects the very foundation of European values. And I may say, as Director General for Democracy, this situation is a threat to democracy in Europe. Finally, the conference told us that the spiral methodology, which involves the local level in the work for the well-being of all with less resources, is a significant tool in our fight against poverty and inequality. One could say the general idea behind this conference is that of fostering. We are not only interested in creating a debate at the national or international level. We have observed how the citizens have responded to the crisis and how they have been organizing innovative means to tackle privation and straits. From time banking to pharmacist network, from the community land trust, which gave a different approach to housing, to projects involving the reuse of electronic and digital equipment. In this respect, the conference and the follow-up meeting tomorrow will surely encourage the creation of specific actions at local level. In cooperation with the European Commission, 2013 will be devoted to enhancing the local capacity to reduce poverty in European cities. Responding together, engaging citizens in reducing poverty and inequality. In the name of the project that will be, that's the name of the project that will be combining citizens' mobilization with an online platform producing information on how to better use local resources to reduce poverty and precariousness. We have high hopes for the success of this project. And this is in no small part due to the debates we have had at this conference here yesterday and today. I thank you all very much for your commitment and your creativity with which you participated. Let me thank also both the colleagues in the EU and my team in DG2, Director General for Democracy, for a long and hard work to prepare this valuable conference. I would also like to thank interpreters for their help for conference to understand each other. This is for the interpreters. On behalf of the Council of Europe, I wish you a good and safe return journey and the energy that is necessary to never back down in the fight for the social rights of everyone, for equality and solidarity, and for dignity of human being. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Dear colleagues, new strategy for social cohesion says that social cohesion is the capacity of society to ensure the well-being of all its members, to manage differences and division, and ensure the means of achieving welfare for all members. You can catch it's quite complex and difficult goal. And it is essential for fulfillment of core values, human rights and democracy. And poverty injures these core values. We were talking about that during these 2 days. Living in poverty is dangerous not just because of low income, deprivation, health problem, low education, emotional disorders, joblessness, big differentiation, vertical and horizontal, of income, and living conditions divide society, infringe its integrity. We see slow economic growth or even recession in some countries now, substantial financial consolidation, falling income levels. All these processes result into deepening poverty and widening inequality. We talk about that in the European Union Social Protection Committee as well. Seeking better results, it is necessary to reconsider interventions applied earlier and their logic, to invoke new methods for ensuring common well-being, promoting societal progress, supporting integration and solidarity. And for this purpose, shared social responsibility shall be exercised through consultations and partnership between different interests. Fair solutions can be found. During 2 days, we had a possibility to discuss these issues in various formats, and it gave a measurable incentive to seriously evaluate the situation, the work done, and even more so, prospects and adequate tools for future. We are here with different backgrounds, representing different sectors and countries. For instance, being from government side, I'm not sure that, for instance, tech rising can be the best solution as it was said in one of the workshops. Lithuania experienced that. We introduced property tax and it resulted in small amount paid by very few rich people. So novelties introduced into tax system shall be very well balanced and least harmful for economic growth. And about austerity measures, we face almost all now. In certain cases, they can be considered maybe as a way of revising existing systems and making them just more effective, who knows. We should define the values we are talking about. I do agree with some speakers that very often state support comes when it is too late, and strongly advocate ideas that instead of fighting with consequences, we should prevent poverty and promote employment. Nevertheless, there is no the only or unique or single solution for all us, it's clear. And the way forward can be described as a complex matter. We do see the continuous need to combat poverty and social exclusion by integrated policies, structural and long-term reforms, and social innovations and investments, which is more difficult in low-growth scenario, yet more indispensable. A few aspects in this way must be mentioned. Commitments by all stakeholders playing a role in reducing poverty and ensuring social cohesion and social justice and consolidation of their action, and shifting from theory to practice. Besides, the last one leads me to an idea that sometimes it's enough to have one person who can put progressive things into practice. And this time I have in mind Gilda. She's the soul of this conference. So great thanks for here, for that event. And final words. As it was mentioned by Massachusetts Institute of Technology, a profound lack of hope, not just capital, goods, credit, skills, or food, could create and sustain poverty trap. So we all need to have a hope. Hope to find and ensure ways out of poverty, and hope to live in dignity and safety. Governmental Committee on Social Cohesion works on building a Europe of shared and social responsibilities, maybe not revolutionary, but sustainable and long-term measures alongside new approaches could lead us into social cohesion. Thank you all.
Mesdames et Messieurs, la crise économique actuelle impose la nécessité de chercher et trouver de nouvelles approches et stratégies de lutte contre la pauvreté et d'assurance du bien-être de tous les membres de la société. Pendant ces deux jours, nous avons eu la possibilité d'attendre les résultats de recherche et l'expérience de différents pays que chacun de nous pourrait adapter à sa situation particulière. Je suis fermement convaincue que la cohésion sociale et la co-responsabilité au niveau local, national, mais aussi international est la solution optimale de plusieurs problèmes en Europe. C'est pourquoi seuls nos efforts communs et l'implication de chacun apporteront des résultats réels. Je voudrais féliciter les organisateurs de la conférence pour leur travail et souhaiter à nous tout beaucoup de courage et de succès dans la promotion des droits sociaux, surtout dans les conditions de la crise économique. Merci.
Well, with this, Gilda, are you going to close the conference formally or give us technical day details? No?
There is a film for anyone who would like to come to the Odyssey on a beautiful film on Pauvre Nous.
So please come to see the film, and I wish you all the best. And with this, I declare the conference officially closed. Thank you.
Thank you very much.